And we're out celebrating our new initiative with our partnerships with moving to a greener fuel efficient bus. We partnered with the federal government and received a grant to purchase 14 new propane fuel fired buses. And we're really excited about this move. The Austintown schools have been really working on moving to become a more greener district.
People of Austintown, first and foremost, should be thankful that we got the grant, we got the buses. But then the added incentive of having it be propane is that if you look at Ohio today, in the eastern corridor of our state, the gas and oil industry is making great strides.
There are a couple things that really stood out to me. One being that propane is 98% made in America, which is huge to me. Also, we've piloted a lot of programs at Austintown in the past. This is probably one of the biggest ones we've done.
Austintown schools have been, you know, pushing to become greener. We have lots of new buildings, new energy efficient buildings. Now we have a new energy efficient fleet. For the last 14 years, my privilege has been to teach the DARE program in our schools. So we're concerned about the safety and health of our children here in Austintown. And these school buses are a wonderful addition to both health and safety.
I've been working with Clean Fuels Ohio on a grant for propane buses. In the very beginning, the drivers were a little apprehensive about the whole propane bus idea. And you know what? We did a little more investigation, and you know what? Now they are so excited. They can't wait to drive those buses.
You know, it's one of those things that vehicles had always been running on propane, and you said you were going to run them on gasoline, which is toxic and volatile and more flammable, then people would probably be worried about that. In addition to it being a domestic fuel and a clean burning fuel, it saves fleets a lot of money. So with the new propane systems, they actually function a lot like a gasoline system. You have a lot of the same components. So just kind of once you learn the properties of the fuel, and you apply that to what you already know about engines and fuel systems, I find it's pretty quick for people to pick up on it on the technical side.
But now the more I've been hearing about it, I'm not afraid to get in there and do what I got to do to it. You know, especially by after tomorrow, I think we're ready to go. Hopefully, being new buses, we don't have to do anything to them for a while.
We had to get other people involved, Clean Fuels Ohio, Roush, some of the local propane providers. We had to get them involved too and be an expert team, not just an individual. One thing about these buses that a lot of the folks in the community won't realize until they start running every day, but how quiet they are. They are just like your automobile that you hear driving down the street. The other thing is these units heat up just pretty much like your car does. It's not instantaneous, but it's very close to that.
As far as the propane industry is concerned, this is going to be a big part of the future of the industry. Propane is used for a lot of different applications, but this is one that it seems to be growing here, especially large in the last couple of years.